I'm going to be looking at something called timing. We have pressure, we have volume, and we have flow cycles. If you recall from the previous slide, I talked that cycles are the things that will end the inspiratory phase. So cycle, always keep in mind, it is ending the inspiratory phase, right? Keep that in mind because that's very important. So when I say time cycle or pressure cycle, it's different from something called time control or pressure control. It's two different things. And an example of a time cycle is this one. So time cycle ventilator will behave in this manner, similar to what the first part of the schematic or the top part of the schematic. So what happened here is that we have pressure and we are asking the ventilator to raise the pressure from a baseline to a specific pressure and hold it for a certain period of time, push it inside the patient lung, and then stop after a certain period of time to allow for the patient to do exhalation and repeat the same thing again and again. Remember that this ventilator is actually time cycled. We are using pressure in it. It's called pressure controlled, but it's a time cycled ventilator. Pressure control means that you are asking the ventilator to increase the pressure and hold it for a certain period of time. So you can control it with the pressure. And then after a certain period of time, you close the inhalation valve and open the exhalation valve for the patient to exhale. And that is a time cycled pressure controlled ventilator. If we would like to look at something called pressure cycle, a pressure cycle is different from a time cycle, and this is not a pressure cycle. A pressure cycle, you are asking the ventilator to increase the pressure for a certain point, and after that point, immediately, it stops and allow exhalation. That is called a pressure cycle. Remember that cycle is the thing that's going to stop inhalation or the inspiratory phase. A schematic of a pressure cycle will look something like this. So if I'm talking about pressure cycle, it will be something like this. You increasing the pressure to a certain point and then it drops down. Sorry, it drops down to zero or to the baseline. So you draw up and then go to the baseline here. That's a pressure cycle. Remember, cycle is the thing that's going to stop the inspiratory phase. So I'm raising the pressure to a certain point, to a certain value, and then after that we stop. We have something also that's called volume cycle, and this is an example. The one at the bottom, the blue line, is a volume cycle. So what happens is that you are increasing the volume of the air flowing into the lungs to a certain point, and then when it reaches that specific volume in milliliters, then you stop the inspiratory phase and allow expiratory phase to take place. That's volume cycle, volume controlled. So volume cycle, volume controlled. Control. That's very important. The last cycle that I would like to explain is something called flow cycle. And that is the green line here, the middle. And the flow cycle, you are asking the ventilator to increase the flow of gas into the patient. After a certain point, it will start to go, the flow will start slowing down. Instead of increasing, start decreasing because there is a resistance, because there is air already inside the lungs, the flow will start getting smaller and smaller and smaller. Now, if you reach, let's say, 25% of the peak flow, this is peak flow, we are setting the ventilator that if you are reaching 25% of peak flow, close the valves of the inspiratory phase and allow the patient to exhale, and that is this jump down here and go back to zero. So what happened is in the flow cycle, we are increasing the flow, and then set to a certain point, then the flow will start getting smaller and smaller because of resistance in the lungs. And we are setting that at 25% of the peak flow, that's my ending point. Just open the valves for exhalation and stop pushing gas inside the lung. And that is what we mean by a flow cycle. I hope that this is explaining for us the time cycle, pressure cycle, flow cycle, and volume cycle. Keep in mind that cycles means is the thing that is going to stop the pushing of the air inside the lungs, and pressure control and volume control are two different things from we're saying pressure cycle. Pressure control, time cycle is a pressure control. A volume cycle is a volume control, because once the volume reaches a certain point, we stopped pushing air inside the lungs. And hopefully now we know the difference, or the what we mean by time, volume, and pressure and flow cycles actually in a ventilator. If you reach this point, thank you so much for watching, and hopefully that was helpful. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to write them in the comment section, and I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. Thank you so much, and until the next video. In the next video, I will be talking also more about the modes of ventilation. So stay tuned. Bye.